Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Tech with Sach. My name is Sachin, a Google developer expert, and in this episode, we will learn how to extend your Android apps to Google Assistant using App Actions. If you're new to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button as well as the bell icon so that you can be notified for future videos. So without further ado, let's get started. Ever wondered how you can use the power of Google Assistant and voice to access and control your Android applications? So in this session, we will learn how to add app actions to your app using built-in intents, navigate to features within the app, search for contents using in-app search, and finally, test common built-in intents with App Actions Test Tool plugin. Let's get started. Before we start the implementation, let's understand how it works. App Actions connects users from Google Assistant to your Android app. But how do they work? So when a user indicates to Assistant that they want to use your app, Assistant looks for App Actions registered to your app from a shortcuts.xml file. This file contains the app capabilities, which then links an Assistant built-in intent or a custom intent to an Android intent or deep link. So let's look at this specific flow. When a user says a query to the Assistant, Assistant passes the user's input and matches it to an App Actions intent. In this code lab, it will be a built-in intent. Assistant then knows which capabilities you support from your shortcuts.xml file. With the intent match, the capability with that built-in intent contains how you want to fulfill that request. In this code lab, the fulfillment is an Android intent that launches an activity in your app. To begin, let's set up our development environment. This code lab starts with a to-do list sample app for Android. Users of this sample app can add items to to-do list, search for items by category, and view information about completed tasks. So let's go ahead and download the sample app by cloning the GitHub repository as shown. Once you've cloned the repository, open it in Android Studio. In the Welcome to Android Studio dialog, click Import Project. Find and select the folder where you have cloned the repository. For those who are joining us for the very first time, make sure to check out the previous tutorials on how to extend your Android applications for the Google Assistant. If you're new to this channel, also make sure to check out the other tutorials on chatbots and voicebots. So coming back to this tutorial, the next step would be to update your application ID. So the reason for this is in the later part of this tutorial, we'll be using App Actions Test Tool to test your actions on an Android device or an emulator. So to run the test tool requires your app to be first uploaded to a project in the Google Play console. To avoid a duplicate package name error when uploading your app to the Play console, we need to change the sample app's application ID to something unique to you. So in the app build.gradle file, update the application ID from com.example.myapp value to a unique ID. In this case, we are updating it to TechWithSach. After updating the application ID, you may see a message which says Gradle files have changed since last project, sync. If so, make sure you click on the sync now in the box to avoid issues that may occur when uploading your app to the Play Store or the Play Console. Let's go ahead and test this application and run it on our device and see what this application is all about. So before making any more changes to the app, it's helpful to get an idea of what exactly the sample app can do. So try running the app on an emulator or on your Android device. So let's briefly explore the app to see what it can do. The application is fairly simple. So tapping the plus icon creates a new task item, and the menu items on the top right allows you to search for and filter task items by completion status. As you can see, each task has a title, description, and once you hit the check mark, that specific task gets created. You do have the ability to filter tasks by different status, cycling through between active and completed. Now that we have a basic understanding of the base application and how it works, our aim is to voiceify this application or control the same set of features through voice. So to do that, the next step would be to upload this application to the Play Console. Uploading the app to a project in the Google Play Console is one of the prerequisites for using the App Actions Test Tool. So build your app in Android Studio and upload it to the Play Console as an internal release draft. So to do that, go to build or generate a signed bundle or APK. In the Google Play console, upload the app bundle you just created as a new app. On the All Apps page, click Create App, give the app any name you want and click Create App. For this code lab, you won't need to fill out any of the app information once the app is created. Just fill out the basic information as shown and click on Create App. On the sidebar menu, go to Testing and find the Internal Testing page. Click Create New Release on the Internal Testing page. Once that is done, click Continue to agree to app signing by Google Play. In the App Bundles and APKs panel, upload the AAB file you just generated earlier. It's likely in the app prod release directory. Once you locate the AAB file that you generated earlier, locate it and upload it into the console. Once the file is uploaded, click on Save. So the next step is to install the test plugin. So the App Actions Test Tool plugin allows you to test your app actions for a single user on a test device. If you do not already have this test tool, install it by following these steps. Go to File, Settings in Android Studio. If you're on Mac, you can select it under Preferences. In the Plugins section, go to the Marketplace and search for Google Assistant or the App Actions Test Tool. Once that is installed, you can go ahead and restart Android Studio. Note that the test plugin sends information to the assistant through the Google app on your Android device. So the next part of this tutorial is where we really start to voiceify our Android application. The next thing is to add the getThing built-in intent capability. So the actions.intent.getThing built-in intent extends your in-app search functionality to Google Assistant. So in this step, you will implement and test the getThing built-in intent, enabling your users to search for specific tasks in the sample application. So the getThing built-in intent is used to search for content or entities using the default in-app search feature in your Android app. Populate the search criteria with the content or entity name using the thing.nameIntent parameter and present the most relevant search results to your user. To add the getThing built-in intent to your app, update the shortcuts.xml file located in App Source Main under Resources and XML. We need to update the shortcuts.xml file with a capability element within the top level shortcuts tag. So with the configuration that we have done, what we are basically doing is declaring that the app responds to the getThing built-in intent. We also specify how to build an Android intent that launches the app in response to that built-in intent. The activity is identified using the target package and target class. The built-in parameter thing.name is mapped into the intent extra named queue. The named activity must be present in the app's manifest and exported. The provided Android application contains metadata, so the Android manifest is aware of the shortcuts.xml file. It's time to test our app actions. To test in-app search for your app from the assistant, follow these steps. Make sure your Android device is connected. Go to Tools, Google Assistant, and App Actions Test Tool. Click Create Preview to accept the default values for app name and locale. In the first step, where the tool asks you to select and configure a built-in intent, select actions.intent.getThing. Change the name value from running shoes to milk. Click Run App Actions. In this test, the getThing built-in intent uses the name attribute to search the app for tasks containing milk. Like the previous app action, you can test your actions using the test tool or simply say, "Hey Google, search for cake mix in task list," or other search phrases on your test device. As mentioned before, the getThing built-in intent is used to search for contents or entities using the default in-app search feature in your Android application. So in this case, as you can see within the test tool, change the name to milk and run the app action. Once you click on App Actions, it will automatically trigger the Google Assistant and it should automatically open the app and get the milk item from the task. So now that we have done with the Get Thing built-in intent capability, let's go ahead and add the Open App feature built-in intent. So in this step, you implement the Open App feature, enabling your users to view their active and completed task using the assistant. So to do this, complete the capability in shortcuts.xml, which contains information on how the capability is triggered, how parameters are passed, and which Android intents to invoke. For this code lab, you'll be using Open App feature built-in intent. As you can see, we are adding two shortcuts with the Open App feature for active and completed tasks. You can also go ahead and drill down further and change some of the keywords used while opening the application or to trigger the app actions. So let's go ahead and test this out. Hey Google, show completed in example application. Hey Google, show active in example application. As you can see, we have successfully enabled app actions for our Android applications. Now we have the power of voice and Google Assistant to control your Android applications. So with that being said, if you did enjoy this tutorial, make sure to hit that like and subscribe button as well as the bell icon so that you can be notified for future videos. Hope you guys enjoyed this video and see you all in the next one.